heated argument going on, happening right now on social media platforms, especially on Twitter, between Ruben Dias and Virgil van Dijk, who is the best defender in the world right now as we speak. Of course, Liverpool fans rooting for their own, while objective fans like ourselves think that, you know, Dias can take the role of, considering what he's done recently, heroic exploits he's put in place in Champions League football, helping his team to cement qualification slot to the final, which is set for Istanbul in Turkey. But as we speak, Champions League football is in jeopardy over surging numbers of COVID.
Yeah, there was even information that it may not be held there. It may be taken to another country, maybe in England, because of the surging numbers. I think that will be a big blow to the Turkish government because of the financial implications and what they could have brought to the table. It's a waiting game.
It's a waiting game. Of course, this Eric Aganya, Man United fan, Okona Kiburi Sana now putting on a jersey because they have qualified to the final of Europa League. Ken Andrew, coincidentally, is also a United fan. Come on, man. In a dilemma here. Quite unfortunate interviewing Vijana wa Kiburi. And now they are finishing second in English Premier League. Ken, I don't know, Champions League football happened in midweek. Europa League football happened as well. PSG hoped that probably they would, for the second time running, seal a spot in Champions League football final. It didn't come to pass. Pep Guardiola, you know, put up what he did to beat his longest rival of all times in Mauricio Pochettino.
Yeah, you know, the City were just brilliant that night, you know. Mahrez was on his game, KDB was on his game, Zinchenko and Walker on their game, and PSG, Mbappe didn't start. He had an injury, and the guy they started, Icardi, he didn't really produce much. He seemed out of order, and Neymar also didn't bring his best boots or whatever. He was overwhelmed by the game. City came into the game looking to go into their first final with Pep, and they did. They played absolutely well over the since the second half of the first leg. City have been absolutely fantastic. And as you said, between Diaz, this season has just been immense for them. You look at the blocks he made in that game, they're just crazy. You know, you need a guy like that, a defender who will put his body into any place to make sure the ball doesn't go in to win titles. And they're in the final now.
Rico, yourself?
I think PSG, as I had stated earlier on my social media, is that they shot themselves in the foot. They had an opportunity to kill the game in the first
during
half.
During the first leg.
Yeah.
Or the first half, they could
have scored. But conceding two goals was complacent of them.
Yeah. I don't know what happened, because when they came in the second half, they lost purpose.
Yeah.
That's when you find a big game manager in Pep Guardiola. Pep Guardiola kept his cool, kept his players to be calm, and eventually they scored the two goals. And that changed the equation.
And actually, even before the second leg, he had revealed that they were not under pressure. They were going into the
pressure.
Second leg.
Exactly.
Enjoy the
they
game.
Were not under pressure, because another thing they knew that PSG, they are coming to frustrate PSG. And I remember PSG are making the same mistake they made last season. They have discipline issues. In both games, they had red cards. The first game, the midfielder got a red card. The second game, they also had a red card. You see, those are lack of objective.
Purely from frustrations?
Frustrations. Yeah. Because you're going for the goal, and Pep Guardiola tells his players, you keep calm, take a lot of time in having those throw balls. You see, they get frustrated.
Yeah.
And then it goes up. So
it looks mistakes. Like the opponents are engaging
exactly.
in time-wasting
exactly.
strategy.
And that's a strategy. And PSG fell into it. I was really disappointed in Mauricio Pochettino, because he's been there before.
Yeah.
In the final, he saw what his players did with Tottenham against Liverpool. So I thought he would approach the game in a better way. But unfortunately, it is what it is. And we are going to have an all-English final.
An all-English final indeed. Now on Wednesday, Real Madrid, 12-time Champions League winners, were knocked out of elite club football competition in Europe by Chelsea, something that was not expected. But you know, Chelsea had an away goal, which was very crucial for them. Zinedine Zidane's brilliance was, you know, tamed completely.
Yeah, I think Chelsea over the two legs, they just looked in better shape than Real. You know, they were running onto everything. Kante was immense. He was winning every ball, battling out in the midfield. And Kai Havertz also, when he played in the second leg, he was absolutely unplayable because he was, every time he got the ball, he's going into the Real defense. The defense looked leaky, even though Ramos was there. I think Chelsea really deserved it because of how they played. They went to the game like they really wanted it. They won all the battles. They're defending. Edouard Mendy made some splendid saves. Chelsea, for that team, are still a young team, still a team with people learning the trade in England. For them to beat Real and be in a major final like this, it will be amazing. And all credit to Thomas Tuchel, because ever since he stepped foot at Stamford Bridge, they've been amazing.
Kolo Kante has been voted second week running as UEFA Champions League player of the week, and he's been, you know, such a revelation for the
Well deserved. He's well deserved. If you look at the first game against Atletico Madrid,
yeah.
He locked Atletico out of the midfield. That is not something easy to do,
yeah,
when you have the likes of Kinakoke in the Atletico midfield.
Yeah.
Come to this game against Real Madrid, he was able to lock Real Madrid out of
Toni Kroos. Toni was Kroos. Not seen.
Luka Modric. Those are big names in midfield,
yeah,
and that's what made the difference.
At some point, Casemiro had to be substituted.
Yes, if you see a game where Casemiro normally is the spoiler, he has to be taken out, then that was it. And that shows you how important N'Golo Kante is to Chelsea. If he gets an injury today, Chelsea will not win anything.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. The two finals there, they are likely to lose, because he's the last piece. And then, as he has mentioned, Eduardo Mendy in the goal, he has been immense.
Yeah.
He's kept quite a number of clean sheets. And all credit goes to Thomas Tuchel, the organization. He's made Chelsea to be solid. He's made Chelsea to be compact. They're not giving away so many goals. They're losing 1-0, 2-1, 1-1. You see, such kind of things.
Timo Werner scored an easy goal, of which if I was the one, I would have scored. But he equally wasted a lot of opportunities. Pulisic was in scintillating form when he got onto the pitch. Do you think now Tuchel will prefer him at the expense of
I don't know why Tuchel sticks to Timo Werner. If it was another coach, I think I would have given somebody else an opportunity.
Yeah.
Because he can really be costly in the big games. Because as a striker, when you get some big chances and you don't put them away, they may come to haunt the team. And they have Giroud in the squad,
yeah,
who is a non-goal scorer. I think Timo Werner is running out of time.
People are castigating Kai Havertz after his move from Borussia Dortmund, but now he's proving his critics wrong. He's been, you know, such a great
Havertz
addition to Chelsea squad.
Yeah, he's performed better than Timo, you know. Coming in, he was naturally he's a 10, but he's never going to push Mount out of the team because Mount is such an amazing player.
Leverkusen.
Yeah, he came. He was their star player at Leverkusen. He came to Chelsea. He found other bigger names around him. You know, you're not the key man. He had to adjust his gameplay to learn to be a team player, and he's done well over the season. You know, he scored great goals. You know, his finishing this season has been better than Timo's, because we've looked at some of the things that Timo is missing. And you just have to feel for Giroud and Tammy Abraham, because
they are on their way out, right?
Yeah, because you can only watch so much, you know. I remember the game against West Ham, he scored one, a hard goal, but he missed an absolute sitter.
He reminds me of Adebayo.
Yeah.
What Adebayo used to do with us. Get 9 chances and score 1.
Mm.
And you see, the tragedy with Timo is that not only in Chelsea, even in the German
league. Yeah, even in the German league.
The other day when they were playing the Euro qualifiers, you wonder, what was the hype all about last season?
Yeah, you know.
What is it that he's not adjusting to?
Maybe it's, I think he's
he
just lost it.
Maybe.
Yeah,
that has always been the line.
Yeah, maybe time.
No, he's running out of patience, because again, you see, what will happen is that the coach will now realize that there are better options.
Yeah.
And if Giroud is allowed to leave and Tammy Abraham is getting impatient, he's young, he wants to get chances to prove himself,
yeah,
you may find them, that's why they're talking about Haaland,
yeah,
coming in. Because if Timo Werner was good, as advertised earlier, they'll not be talking about Haaland. And you see right now,
but Chelsea has plenty of attacking options up front.
Natural number nine.
Yeah,
natural number nine.
They don't have one.
They don't have one. They're banking on Timo Werner. Because if you look at Giroud is aging. He's 36 or 35?
Yeah.
36. He's aging. And you see now they need to bring in young blood. Because I think what Tuchel is trying to do is
he's building out a budding squad.
He will dominate football for quite a time.
Yeah.
So, an all-English final affair, Pep against Tuchel. It's going to be a crunch tie, right?
Yeah, it is, you know.
But you see other people saying, we've seen pundits on TV saying that, you know, it will lack that oomph for a Champions League final because they're coming from the same league.
Yeah, no, but we saw United versus Chelsea in 2008. Yeah,
so
it was
Atletico versus Real.
It was amazing. It will not lack. And City and Chelsea.
Maybe what Chelsea will do, the problem will they will lock the game.
So yes.
It will be a 1-0, 2-1. You see, people are expecting an open game where they want free scoring.
Where are you putting your money, Eric?
I'll put my money with the experience.
I'll put my money on Tuchel because. That, you know, denying him scoring goals and also having a proper guys to attack.
And in the event that Chelsea wins the title, I think it will be more of happiness to the coach himself, Tuchel, and Thiago Silva. Remember they missed out on the silverware last season in the final after losing to Bayern.
Yeah, I think it will also be...
And even the young kids,
the likes of Mason Mount.
Even Abramovich himself. Remember, he was castigated when he fired Lampard. Remember, Lampard is a legend. The fans were not really happy. But when Tuchel came in, the results started improving. Now, he got away with it.
So the Russian billionaire would have proven his critics wrong.
Exactly. So he really wants it to remain in London, the trophy to remain. But what I think both trophies will go to Manchester. The Euro, the Champions League and the Europa. They reside in Manchester.
Nilikuambia, wako na kiburi. Nilikuambia, unaona kiburi. Anyway, let's go to what happened on Thursday night football, Europa League. Arsenal spoiling the party for English Premier League because it was expected that maybe four teams would have participated in the finals of both UEFA Champions League and Europa League. But now, failing to score that one goal that was very paramount to their qualification.
I'm struggling to look for words because I have a few friends who are Arsenal fans and they're really on my case because they're telling me every now and then I call them Kaleka team. But they've proven they're Kaleka team.
Yep.
I think Arsenal are just a joke. The players, they lack passion for the team because if you look at the squad they had, the goals that they have in them, how did they fail to score one goal against Villarreal? But we have to give credit to Unai Emery. Unai Emery is not somebody to take for granted because he's proven himself in the Europa. He won it with Sevilla 3 times. Now he has, for the first time ever, he has taken Villarreal to the final. But Arsenal need a total overhaul, starting with the coach. And then you come in, they have players like Aubameyang, since he got another contract, he's not performing. And to make matters worse, he's the captain, so he cannot...
So you want to get rid of Arsenal squad if you are given powers?
They have to
there has to be continuity.
They have to get rid of some dead wood. They bought Willian from Chelsea. I think he should be cursing himself why he left Chelsea when Chelsea are now winning, are going to the verge of winning the Champions League.
Yeah.
You look at the players they have in their squad. There are so many dead ones. They need a leader.
They need a leader. Ken, and United against Roma, Red Devils had sort of, you know, sealed their place in the final after that 6-2 demolition of the Italian giants, but it looked like Roma were really looking forward for stylish comeback to ensure that, you know, they beat United by a good scoreline. They needed like four.
Yeah, they needed four, and they almost got. But United, thanks to Cavani, the two away goals, Roma needed a little bit more than that. And also, apart from Cavani, David De Gea had one of his best games as a United player. He made a lot of world-class saves that no other goalkeeper can make, you know, things that weren't expected. Were it not for the great performances by Cavani, Bruno and De Gea, I think United would have would have really suffered because Roma, they went out, but with their pride intact. They played like a proper top European team, despite all those injuries to almost half of their first 11 players. They still managed to show up, you know. And you look at the game between United and Roma and Villarreal and Arsenal, and you look at, take Villarreal out of those three teams, Arsenal, I don't even know. They couldn't score one goal, and that is really, really scary. You have guys like Aubas, just let it go. They, as he said,
after the outcome that night, Mazai was sympathizing with Arsenal fans on Twitter, saying that better Arsene Wenger.
Why were you sympathizing with them? Yet they are loud mouth. They talk a lot. As you say, Situ kuna kiburi, but Arsenal fans, they were already budgeting for Manchester United in the final, and they had not won.
Budgeting.
Yes, they were thinking of how they'll beat Manchester United in the final, but they had not made it to
even
the final.
Even before the second leg clash against exactly. Villarreal.
But as he says, the best thing that Manchester United did was to score very many goals in the first leg.
Yeah.
Had they not done that, then they'll be out. They could have been out of the final too, because Roma, the second leg, came with the intention of knocking Manchester United out, and they could have done it, but the brilliance of Bruno Fernandes, David De Gea made 10 saves in that game, 10 crucial saves. I think we could be talking about something else.
Wow. So let's speak about another development amongst our talking points. Which one? Of course, we've exhausted about Champions League football and Europa League. So next is Inter Milan winning Scudetto after, you know, several years of dominance by Juventus. And I think it looks like it's a hotly contested battle for top four finish. Yeah. Because Juventus,
Napoli,
and who else? Napoli are fighting for that slot to qualify for Champions
League. There's Atalanta,
and Atalanta
is,
as well.
Lazio is,
and also today, I think, is a crunch tie in Italy.
Mm-hmm. Big game and a big season for Conte, and he's proven himself as a winner because he came to Chelsea and won.
Despite signing what most people referred to as rejects.
Rejects, and look at what he's done with Inter Milan. He went for players who have proven themselves and tested themselves and proven, the likes of Sanchez, the likes of Ashley Young, the likes of Lukaku. These are players who have proven themselves somewhere else. And Conte has one thing that very many managers don't have: how he motivates his players. He makes his players feel like they are everything. And I can equate that to a friend of mine who was telling me.
That's why Romelu Lukaku is very happy.
He's very happy. He makes Romelu Lukaku feel like he's the best striker ever in the world. So when that player walks onto the field, he wants to perform for his manager. And that's what those players have done. Mm-hmm. And congratulations to them. I pity Pirlo because he's a legend. He may finish out of the top four if he's not careful.
And that's why I think that's what Naro was saying. Most better and prolific players don't make, you know, great managers.
Yeah, just because you played doesn't mean you'll become a good manager.
Yes.
Playing and management are two different things. Because if you look at some of the best managers, Klopp, he has no history of being an outstanding player. Mourinho, he has no history of being an outstanding. Look at even Sir Alex Ferguson himself. They were the best managers, some of the best managers in modern football. Look at some of the best players who have tried management. Look at what happened to Gary Neville when he tried Valencia.
Thierry Henry.
Yeah. So those are two different things.
So Romelu Lukaku, Lautaro Martinez, their partnership up front, has it been significant to Inter's case to win Scudetto?
Yeah, because they don't miss a lot of chances, you know, those two. And aside from those two, they have a team which is full of professionals. You know, that's the best thing about it. They don't get complacent very easily. They'll play their hearts out every 90 minutes. And not just the 11, but you look at the team he has on the bench, it's still top tier professionals, people who have proven themselves. And I think even though he's won the Scudetto, Conte will be displeased because the last two seasons with that squad he's not made it out of the group stages of the Champions League. I think that will be his next goal, to try and go for it, because
we have seen how they've Milan were running away with it, but Inter came back and absolutely shot forward, won the league. They won the league with games to spare, you know. They have been absolutely amazing, and all credit to Lukaku. He's receiving the praise he deserves right now. He's been outstanding. He had a poor stint at Man United, not like this one. This one, he's been the key player, the key man, and you've seen what he's done.
And how comes United fans are upset with Ashley Young over that photo they took, you know, former United players now at Inter Milan as teammates, having won the title while United are still languishing in...
You can't really blame them.
Trophyless.
Yeah,
situations.
The four of them, like Damian, was kind of on the fringe, you know, at United. Young.
He's still a fringe player at Inter. Yeah. Does he play frequently?
Yeah, he's played. He's got a couple of goals this season. I've seen him. He scored. But the thing here is, I think they just feel something like it's.
It's a relief, yeah.
You sold us, but look at what you're doing now.
I think the fans were just cheeky. They were just displeased because Manchester United this season has not won the league.
Yeah.
And here are players who left, and they're celebrating winning. So it's just like salt in the wound for Manchester United fans. But as he says, look at those players who went to Inter. They are natural winners.
Yeah.
And that is what has helped Inter. Look at what Zlatan did single-handedly at Milan when he came in. He brought that winning mentality, and I gave them a good run. But injuries also took a pile, and that's how Inter shot and were able to win the Scudetto. Mm-hmm. Congratulations.
Before we review what will be happening, the mouth-watering ties happening this particular afternoon, of course, in Serie A, it's Barcelona in La Liga. Yeah. Barcelona up against Atletico Madrid. It's wide open for any of them to win title this particular season, and the game is later to take place 5:15 p.m. East African time. Before we get there, Roma has got a new coach from next season, Jose Mourinho. This man,
Jose Mourinho,
he never misses lacks. On employment even after getting sacked from this club.
He's made
that's a few weeks ago. He was fired by Tottenham.
Yeah.
Then a few weeks later, he gets an opportunity to coach in Italian football to make a return because he's been there before.
Yeah. He's made a lot of money from his sackings. Yeah. I was looking at it that he's made around 100 million.
Because you have to honor the contract.
In terms of compensation. Yeah. And I think he must be a very shrewd businessman, apart from being a manager. But in him going to Roma, he'll make the Italian league to be more interesting.
Yeah.
Because I can't wait for his run-ins with Conte. They have their rivalry. Both of them.
It will be renewed.
It will be renewed. And that will bring some top quality managers in the in the Italian football, because we have Unai Emery with Villarreal. He'll be backed, he'll be given money, he'll make signings. Definitely, Mourinho does not take a club where he's not assured of making signings.
Yep.
So he's going to reinforce an already good Roma side.
Yeah.
And then you have Napoli, you have Inter, you have AC Milan, and then Atalanta also has come up. So it will be the case of like the English Premier League, where we no longer have the top four, we'll have the top six or top seven.
Yeah.
So it's a good thing for football.
And that will make their league lucrative.
Water title.
You know, ever since Ronaldo came, the coverage increased in that league, and now with Mourinho, who's also a huge figure, the coverage will increase. And as is the documented rivalry between Conte and Mourinho going on, you know, that's a huge source. Everyone will want to see that. And Mourinho is also a top manager. Roma this season, they won't make the Champions League, but the Europa League will be something they'll be looking to go for. And Mourinho is a winner. He'll want to go for the cup and the Premier, the Serie A title. So it's going to be a very tight at the top. Yeah.
So Barcelona up against Atletico. For the sake of investors who are watching the show, they want to place a bet.
Messi is on fire. Messi is performing this season, and it will depend how he comes up today. If he's on fire as he has been, then Barcelona may carry the day because of that one individual brilliance. Remember, Atletico, they started well, but they have a small squad. So fatigue kicked in. They had some poor results in between. We couldn't imagine them losing to Chelsea out of the Champions League. But you see, it happened.
Luis Suarez will be facing against his former employers.
Yeah, that's another.
Is he fit to start?
Yeah,
he's fit to start. I think he's waiting for that game because of what Barcelona did to him. They didn't treat him fair.
I think this game will see, you know, two players facing their former employers, because Antoine Griezmann as well.
Yes, Antoine Griezmann. But Griezmann is a hero at Atletico. He left on good terms.
Yes.
But Suarez did not leave on very good terms.
Yeah.
And it will be a very emotional game. You may expect a red card in this game. Very emotional, because you see, it's going to decide. It's a title decider also. Because if Barcelona loses this one out, then their chances diminish completely.
Yeah, and also there's the other game, Real versus Sevilla.
Yes, another big game. Cracker.
Yeah, it's a big game. I think if Sevilla lose that one, they'll be completely off the pace. Okay, they're already in the Champions League, but wanting to finish above third will be key for them. If they lose this one, that won't be possible. And if the Barca Atletico ends in a draw, that's a huge win. And Real Madrid win, that's a huge win for them. So no, of the three teams, no one should lose. If you want to win the title, if you want to remain in the top two, win your game. And it's going to be very hard for all three clubs.
Now let's finalize our discussion with English Premier League football. Last night, Newcastle up against Leicester 4-2 in favor of the visitors. And Soyuncu, come on, what was that mistake he made that led to, you know, a goal being scored? And I think that was the opener for a lot of goals getting soaked in.
Yeah, I think we saw this with Leicester last season, caving in at the last moment of the league. This season, Harvey Barnes, they've not had many injuries as last, but they're still lacking that mentality, I'd say, to finish the job, get in the top four. Yesterday was just showing the cracks. They need to get their season in check, and I think it will be hard for them with the games remaining. They have United.
They're in trouble. John Evans was injured just a few minutes before the kickoff. Yeah.
They have United, they have Chelsea, they have Tottenham to play. I think they also have Man City to play the remaining five games. They have United.
So there is a likelihood if they continue the way they are performing, they can miss out on the top four finish.
They can miss out on the top four finish. And that will be a big tragedy for them, bearing in mind they have had a relatively good season.
At some point, they were favourites for the league.
Exactly. But I think they went to a point where, by the apart from the injuries, Brendan Rodgers started now prioritizing the FA Cup.
Yeah,
he ends up with a trophy rather than end up number two or number three. Mm. So, but that will be a tragedy, because them missing out on Champions League next season will not be a good showing for them.
Yeah. And they've been in the top four for pretty much the whole. Almost like 2 weeks, they've only missed in the top four, I think, for 3 or 2 weeks of the past two seasons, and it's usually the last week. So they need to get everything in order. They need to get in check. They need to drag themselves over the line and really show us they deserve to be in the Champions
League. That says a lot about a squad. You see, a team with a big squad, when you're competing for 2-3 trophies, towards the end, that's when you find that the big teams with big squads will come and finish properly. You've seen Chelsea coming and giving it the last push, and Chelsea may end up finishing number three at this pace. Leicester lacks that big squad. When they have an injury in Harvey Barnes, they don't have somebody to replace Harvey Barnes. That's the biggest problem.
Of course, some matches on card this particular afternoon. Underway is Tottenham against Leeds, 30 minutes having been played so far. 1-1, Heung Min Son scored and Stuart Dallas equalized. Of course, Dele Alli now starting of late, since Jose Mourinho left, he's been involved in assisting, creating that particular goal. What do you think about the likely outcome? Marcelo Bielsa up to prove a point, Bana, for the first time they are participating after several years.
I heard what I read after they won the last game, Tottenham won the last game 4-0. Gareth Bale was aiming a dig at Mourinho, saying that now they are enjoying football. Why? Because Mourinho is a tactical coach. He's a coach who doesn't allow them to go forward a lot. And I was expecting a lot of goals in this tie, because we have Ryan Mason, who is now young and as a coach, and he will push his guys to go for the attacking. That's why you're seeing Dele Alli starting. And you have Marcelo, of course, he doesn't know anything else. He knows how to attack. So, but through experience, Leeds.
There is no way Ryan Mason will be, you know, retained in that position of a manager.
Yeah. Why?
Daniel Levy wants world class. Yeah, who will deliver a big trophy for them next season?
Who?
I think he has very few games to prove himself. You know, it's end
in
of
the
season.
In the events he deliver?
Yeah. I think you can't.
Rare chances of him retaining the position.
But who is out there?
Allegri is out.
Allegri, only Allegri. Allegri doesn't, is not very conversant in English. Who else?
You know, Ryan Mason, I think, you know, it's his first managerial job, you know. Yes. Coming straight from playing is 2 years a retiree, straight into managing.
Eddie Howe, is he still unattached, former Bournemouth manager?
Yeah, he's still but I saw Celtic were looking for him because Celtic also need a manager. But I think Mason should not get the job permanently. He needs a little bit more of time to really get into the groove of management.
They are going for Brendan Rodgers, but Brendan Rodgers ruled himself out.
Yeah.
I said he's comfortable at Leicester.
Yeah, Leicester at the moment is much better than Tottenham, as a whole.
Stability-wise.
Yeah.
Ashley Young now, on the verge of making a return to his boyhood club, Watford in Skybet Championship, after, I think, doing what he was expected to do with Serie A champions Inter Milan. And I think Ashley Young, can we say he has had a colorful
career. Bearing in mind he's not a very outstanding player. That
yes, he's a team player.
Remember he was bought from Aston Villa, came into Manchester United. He ended up captaining Manchester United. Nobody expected that.
He won a Premier League title with them.
With Manchester United. He's gone to Italy. He's won the Serie A. He has nothing else to prove himself. So he wants to come, have fun, retire. And I think Watford will be okay for him. Bearing in mind, they have now been promoted back to the league.
Yeah, and they'll be getting an experienced player who's done it before. Yeah. So it's a good move for
and
both
he's a boyhood fan, and he started his football there.
Yeah.
Of course, other matches on card this particular afternoon, Sheffield United up against Crystal Palace. They have been relegated, Sheffield, right?
Yep.
Manchester City will be playing against Chelsea. Come on, this is what we are anticipating in Champions League final. Can we say that the win of this particular clash stands a chance of, or it doesn't have any dimension?
It has
or
no
what
impact
we
whatsoever.
Expect.
Yeah, you can't know. Whoever wins today, it's just today's game. The final is a total different thing, you know. It's a one-off game. This is the league. City have it bagged, you know.
Yeah.
Whoever.
So even they might feel a weak squad.
Yeah. No, I don't think.
No, they want to win it.
Yeah, they want to win it first. Completely.
Fast,
so just to stamp the authority.
Just to stamp the authority. But even dropping points, I don't think United can catch up.
Can catch up with them. No. Yeah, they have to lose a lot of games, which Guardiola will not do. This will not determine the
and
final.
And because Chelsea is also not sure of winning Champions League.
In fact,
so they have to.
In fact, Chelsea will be more, will want to win this game more than Manchester City, because they want to cement the top four.
Yeah.
Unlike Manchester City, which they are champions elect. But this game has no bearing on the final, because we are dealing with two unpredictable managers. Both of them are very unpredictable. Pep will spring up a surprise today and tomorrow come up with a different lineup totally. So this will not be a game whereby you want to see what you'll see in the final. No, what you see in the final will be totally different.
Yeah.
You remember Tuchel saying that when he saw the Real Madrid squad out, he threw away what he had planned and came up with another plan. So these are very unpredictable managers, and they adapt so fast.
Ole Gunnar Solskjaer, United manager, is complaining of a crowded schedule in terms of fixtures. Their rescheduled game against Liverpool has been put to
Thursday
next week, and I think in the next 1 week they will
play on Sunday, they play on Tuesday and then Thursday. Same week. 5 days, 3 games.
What a tight schedule for United.
Very, and considering
rotational is the way to go, right?
Yeah, rotation is the way to go, but Ole, I think there are some players who will play all the games because we've seen him do it before.
Like Maguire, Wan-Bissaka.
In the dead rubber games, Real Sociedad home, when we already had 4 goals, he still went on with the guys. Rashford has been playing all through an injury. So I think even with COVID, with the restart, they've learned to play many games. I think though it's a really tough schedule for them, they'll make out of it without injuries, and rotation is there. This is the chance for guys like Van der Beek to really get the minutes.
He played very well against Roma on Thursday.
Yeah, and I think also for him, he has to prove himself in if he's given the 90 minutes in a Premier League game, you know, different intensity, different, they also still need to cement second place, first of all. Yeah. So they have to, all the players will be selected between those three matches, have to really, really come to the front and fight for their team.
Definitely. Gentlemen, your parting shots, your final words ahead of, you know, what looks like, you know, the beautiful tail end of European football, Champions League, Europa League finals, you know, most leagues coming to an end, culmination of what we've been watching for the last few months.
What we're watching, what me I'm watching keenly is the Big Sam. Will he keep West Brom up or will he go down for the first
time?
They're
not yet relegated?
No.
No. Or will he go down for the first time? They're playing Arsenal tomorrow.
I like Big Sam. I would hope to see him in the league.
Because he's never been relegated. He's never been relegated. This may be the first. And if you look at the last three, four games, he's been playing very well. That's the game I'm going to watch tomorrow and see. Yeah. Will Arsenal also shoot themselves in the foot to prove
their sense on the log?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ken, yourself?
Yeah, for me, it will be the La Liga title race, you know. These are crunch games. These are the crunch last three, four games of the season, and it's time to see who really wants this title, you know. It's very tight at the top, and all the teams for some are playing each other at this moment, you know. It's going to be a fun ride in La Liga. Yeah,
definitely. Of course, it's been such a big show. Every Saturday, 1-3 Touchline. Max Oluwasike is my name, my robust panelist coming in through just to give their insights. As far as international football is concerned, preview of what we're looking forward to in terms of, you know, Champions League and Europa League finals. Manchester City up against Chelsea, but they are playing today, but they rule out that, you know, whatever is happening tonight in terms of outcome is will not have a bearing on what we expect in the final, while United will be playing against Villarreal. All eyes on the same. Keep talking to us. Let's keep the conversation rolling. Hashtag Touchline Y254 to Asike Maxwell at Y254 channel. Thanks for coming through. We meet next time, right?
Thank you.
Blessed. Keep safe and have a good weekend.